This Warchief believes he has us where he wants us. Let us show him the error of his ways.
Gondorians are a seafaring people, though our ships ply the coastlines and rivers, rarely venturing into the open sea. Yet it was not always so. Our ancestors, the Numenoreans, and their elven allies sailed to other lands in ships like this model. Sailors even claim it's possible to sail so far into the ocean that land is too distant to see in any direction. Hard to imagine. So I suppose I'll have to see it for myself someday.
Did the elves truly sail in vessels such as these?
In the First Age, this would count among the most ordinary ships in our fleet.
Gondor's roots are literal ones, for our realm is intertwined with the White Tree, our greatest symbol and inspiration. Isildur himself gave our people the sapling that would grow into the White Tree, and it survived attacks from Sauron, plagues, and multiple transplants as Gondor's borders shifted in war. Today, the White Tree stands in our capital, Minas Tirith, though it will not blossom again until the King returns, as my father once said. Thank you.
white tree. Symbol of Gondor.
Your nation will need more than symbols to inspire it soon enough.
Drill instructor told me, trust in your training, not your armor. Even a finely wrought plate can buckle under a hard enough blow, but a skilled warrior can evade that blow so it never lands in the first place. Now Minas Ithil has buckled under. Some blows are impossible to evade, so we do the next best thing. Stand back up again, wounded as we are.
This armor is intended to be ceremonial, yet it seems... enough.
As it should be. Gondor has little need for ceremony of late.
Whatever's out there, we'll taste my blade!
Mine! beast I can't skin. Not sharp enough knife.
That's four times the dose you need! Ever heard of supersaturation?
Ashgarn.
Thing. sing a song will never end.